Ruby's got the clock ticking. It's the waiting game at 7:10. Saturday night on BBC One.
Welcome back, my friends, to the show that never ends. We're so glad you could attend. Come inside, come inside. There behind the glass stands a real blade of grass. Be careful as you pass. Move along, move along. Come inside, the show's about to start. Guaranteed to blow your head apart. Rest assured, you'll get your money's worth. With this show, it happened out on the guaranteed show. It's a dynamo. You gotta see the show. It's rock and roll.
This love game show audiences, ladies and gentlemen. Woo, woo, woo! Tell a joke.
Didn't get that one at all.
Yeah, right. What's new? I only took Leah out to dinner last night. That's all. Don't you worry about that. Yeah, she was really amazed when I ordered the entire meal in Danish. Funny, really. We was in a Chinese restaurant. I only said that to get a little laugh, which is all it got. I'm just waffling away, right, because she's late. Her who should be obeyed. Yes. It's either she's got a new frock, and I've seen it hanging up. Or, right, she's probably gone off to do aerobics. Yes, she does PE every week, right, before the show to try and get in shape. She tries to get me to go with her, but, I mean, come on, do I need it? I mean, be fair. No, I'm not into exercise. I keep telling her, if God had intended us to touch our toes... He would have put our feet halfway up our legs. Wasn't the thing you thought I was going to say, was it? Right, here we go. Here's Leah. I'm not looking. Very nice dress.
Thank you.
When's the rest of it get here? Anyway, you're late. Where you been?
Oh, don't ask.
Okay, I won't ask.
Okay, I'll tell you. Remember I told you I was doing that photo shoot yesterday?
Oh, yeah.
Well, I was at the railway station waiting for the train to come back to London. Ooh. And I fancied a nibble.
Like you do.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
So I rushed into the tea bar. And yeah. There was a horrible, horrible Doris with a face like a toothache standing behind the counter.
Really? She was that bad?
Yes. I've never seen such an ugly woman in my whole life.
Oh, no.
Right. Who's next?
It's me, miss.
Oh, welcome to the new Millennium Bar. All nice, fresh food, lovely and clean. What do you want?
I'll have a cheese sandwich, please.
Cheddar cheese, Gloucester cheese, Leicester cheese, cream cheese, Plowman's, Gouda, Danish blue, full fat, half fat, low fat, no fat, plain toasted, processed or mature.
Any cheese with bread?
Bread, wants bread, white bread, brown bread, rye bread, crisp bread, French bread, farmhouse, wheat germ, with butter, without butter, with pickle, without pickle, pickled onions, pickled cabbage, pickled gherkins, great big pickled gherkins, known as wallets if you come from London, fat bagel, baguette, bun, toasted roll, on a plate, or to go.
Anything. And a cup of coffee?
Black coffee, white coffee, sugarless, decaf, espresso, cappuccino, latte, mocha, cafe au lait, half cream, full cream, no cream, frothy, or camp.
Today, I'll have a packet of crisps.
Cheese, onion, crispy bacon, salt and vinegar, beef, mustard, ham and egg, chicken curry, barbecue pork, with salt, without salt, hand-cooked, family side, medium, small, forget it, there's been a rush on, we've sold out the lot.
All right, I'll have a piece of cake.
Sponge cake, layer cake, larder cake, angel cake, sugar cake, cheesecake, chocolate cake, jam cake, flaky cake, arctic roll, full cake, fairy cake, flaky cake, or perhaps a cream cake.
I'd like a cheese sandwich, please.
Cheddar cheese, Gloucester cheese, Leicester cheese, cream cheese, Plowman's, green cheese, Danish blue, full cake.
That's how I missed my train, Jim.
Oh, don't worry about that. Forget it. Just introduce the people.
Oh, big people, small people, fat people, thin people, too. First tonight, we have Bev and Marcus Pollard.
Then, Leah.
Bev is a dinner lady and Marcus is a student. They're mother and son from Warwickshire.
You're a dinner lady?
Yes.
You have to be sensible to be a dinner lady, don't you? Because you're working with children, OK?
That's
you
right.
don't look too sensible here. Marcus, here's you as a little girl. Marcus, diplomaticus, politicius.
Sort of, yeah.
You're in a bit of that, aren't you?
I am
you
indeed.
Like politics, don't
I do.
You?
My ambition in life is really to be a diplomat, but I know my mum, she wants me to be Prime Minister.
Prime Minister?
Yes.
Well, let's have a look at you as a very serious politician. Now then, mum likes music, yeah?
Yes, if you can, yes.
Boy bands?
Indeed.
Westlife?
Westlife, yeah. Blue. Boyzone.
Boyzone. Would you like to see Blue do their single?
Yes.
Yeah, it's called Long Time. It's a great single. This is a great band. Here they are. It's Blue.
Terry is an office manager and Kelly is a part-time cashier. They're father and daughter from Somerset.
OK, Kelly, you're also a dancer, aren't you, Kelly?
Yeah.
Come on then, show us some steps.
There's no business like show business. Like no business I know.
OK, so you're obviously not a professional dancer. Anything else we should know about?
I used to collect Barbie dolls.
Did you? Barbie's great, you know.
I know.
So how many dolls did you have?
About 25.
Did you?
Yeah.
Did you have Ken?
Yeah, I used to have Ken. I only had one Ken.
You only need one Ken for 25 Barbies. Here you are relaxing before the show.
Oh.
And here you are in Cats. Well, you're a very strange child. Not as much as it is Dad getting trolled. That's obviously some event going on there, TR1. What was all that about, Tell?
It's my 40th birthday.
40th birthday?
Uh-huh.
Blimey, did they have colour film?
Yes, they did. Yeah.
Now, as you know, Dale Winton is a mate of mine.
Mm-hmm.
And I asked him on the show, and he said, Jim, for you,
no.
Forget it. Blobby, bring a trolley out here. It's going to be our Dale Winton.
Stand there, Tel. Right, you can always tell about a person who's got stuff in the trolley.
Yeah.
What's that? What is it?
A what?
What else? Oh, you got one of them singing kettles. Let's listen.
It's not unusual to me.
Shut it down. Put it down.
To have fun with anyone.
Catch them out. It's under the sound department. What's that there? It's the end of that guy.
Is it a banger?
A banger first. Someone put me head out. Right, what else you got? What else you got? I'm gonna kill you for this, Blobby. It's a Barbie!
Yeah.
Oh, look, a Barbie. Can she fly? No. What's this? No more explosions. Tao, otherwise known as Susan. This is Chinese martial arts.
Yeah, Chinese martial arts.
Kung Fu.
Yeah.
Can you do this?
I can, I'm sorry. I'm a musician.
That great, you can accompany me to the dressing room.
Thank you.
Here we are. Snag along. That's very good, very impressive. Hard work, got it. Let's welcome back Susan to give us some marks. Now, Susan,
yeah.
What do you think? Well, they're very good, weren't they?
Yes, very good. Beth, I think when they're fighting, it's very funny. Very humorous. So I give the Beth 8.
8?
8.
8.
And Marcus is 7.
7.
Yeah.
Very good. Good.
Congratulations. Yeah.
Kelly
and Terry.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think Terry is very skilled. And Kelly, you look very lovely. So I give you 7.
7.
And the Terry is 9.
Well, very good. All right, well done.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
What's the scores, Leah?
Bev and Marcus have 15 points and Kelly and Terry have 16 points.
Right, this game knows knees, knows knees, knees. It's a mind game! Right. This is a mind game, right? This is favourite children's songs or nursery rhymes. You're going to put the earphones on so you can put a... And you've got to mime what the tune is and you've got to write it down. Put the earphones on. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Okay, then, let's have the first one. Oh, pardon me. Get back up there, you idiot. That was played by the Baked Bean Ensemble.
Humpty Dumpty.
And we've got Humpty Dumpty.
Hey.
Off. Yeah. What? He's not doing it yet. We ain't started. What's up the next one?
The magic dragon.
Doing it. Isn't it? This. Get back over there, you dragon. You stupid woman. That was Puff, the magic dragon.
Oh.
What have you got, Leah?
Snowman.
The snowman?
Yes.
Ridiculous. We got the owl and the pussycat. Let's have the next one.
The runaway train came down the track and she blew. The runaway train came down the track and she blew.
You sure he's yours?
The runaway train came down the track, her whistle wide and his buckle black.
Look at this idiot here. Ooh, ooh, ooh.
The engineer said the train must halt and she blew. The engineer said the train must halt and she blew.
Wait till you hear this. That was the runaway train came down the track and she blew. What have you got?
Thomas the Tank.
We got a magic roundabout. Let's have the next one. What's that hanging out your back there? Looks like a bit of toilet paper. I know it's scary, this show, but come on. What have you got, Doris?
Hickory Dickory Dock.
And we've got Hickory Dickory Dock.
Hey.
Let's have the next one. That was, I got no strings, and that was Pinocchio.
Pinocchio,
lovely little
yes.
boy. What have you got?
Pinocchio.
Pinocchio. We've got puppets. I can't give you anything for that. Let's see what it adds up to, Leah.
Bev and Marcus have 19 points, and Kelly and Terry have 22 points.
OK, you've won. You've got to go up to that little room over there. 10cc are playing there this week. Quivering bloke for you. I'm a quivering bloke for you. Good luck in politics, mate. It's, you know, it's a serious thing to do.
and start practicing telling fibs now.
Okay.
Give a nice round of applause.
Thank you. Great.
Look, look.
Is he all right?
Yeah. Who's next, Leah?
Next we have
Kath. I'll be okay.
Good. Next we have Kath and David Threadgold.
From Wales, then. Where are they from, Leah?
Kath is a deputy head teacher and David is a police officer. The mother and son from Aberdeen.
You never told me that when I come down there to drink,
did you?
You're not a traffic policeman or anything horrible like that, are you, David?
No, I haven't been in long enough.
You haven't been in long enough. You will be. You'll probably get me as I'm whizzing through Aberdeen. Once I get my licence back. Have a look at that screen, mate. Here you are as a little policeman. Here you are as a big policeman.
What a poser!
OK, moving on. Tell us about your mum's driving, David. Being a police officer, does it disturb you, the fact that she's such a brilliant driver?
She's actually failed her driving test on 5 occasions. She hasn't quite got the concept of driving. We were driving along one time, about 60 miles an hour, second gear, about 9,000 revs, before I mentioned to her that she needed to go up into third. And I was only 7, you know?
Brilliant story. Now then, you're a bit of a hero. Tell us about the dog. First of all, let's see the newspaper article. Rebel saved by hero. So you saved the dog?
Saved the dog, yeah.
Come on, Kath, tell us about that.
Well, he said that he was on duty, yes, and he was patrolling near a river.
A river.
Right. And he heard a plaintive cry of a dog.
A plaintive cry?
Yeah.
Oh. A talking dog?
Yeah. He thought to himself...
He thought to himself...
Yeah, I better jump
in. It's a plaintive cry for a dog!
Yeah. Quickly thinking, jump in, David, and rescue the dog.
But hang on. The mid-story, we go back to newspaper report. Again. Lynn, this is the mummy of the dog, said, then he just took his clothes off, apart from a pair of navy tartan boxer shorts. You... Oh, no!
Now we know! Okay, it's gruesome.
All right, OK. Let's take the next bit, next episode. I always liked a man in uniform, now I prefer a man out of it. Is this the woman whose dog you saved?
This was her, yeah.
Have you seen her since?
I saw her when the press were taking photographs. Yeah.
She's here now, Lynn, and Rebel the dog. Hello, Rebel. What's he been eating? What? Hello, Lynn, how are
Hiya.
You, love? Welcome down for Aberdeen. Kiss him here, I'll hold him. I'll hold him. Come on, Rebel. Good. OK. So, good. Rebel, sit. No, I said sit. What have you got?
Just a little something that I wanted to give Dave Readers.
What is it?
I just wanted to give him this photograph that was in the paper.
Thank you very
Rebel
much.
Looks good anyway.
Dog.
That's great. Now, and don't forget, your friends in the police force won't take the mickey out of you anymore. That's a promise. Right, lads? Give them a nice round of applause. That's a lovely story. Who's next, Leah?
Next tonight, we have Tony and Hazel Knight.
How do they do?
Tony is a business development manager and Hazel is a hairdresser. They're father and daughter from Kent.
How are you, Tony?
All right, thanks.
All right, hi.
Hello.
Okay. Oh, hello. Hazel, here's when you had your first 2 front teeth. Tell us about your hamster. You had a hamster, didn't you?
Yes.
What was his name?
Hammy.
How old were you when you had Hammy?
13.
I bet you was nice then.
Yes.
What happened to Hammy?
Hammy died.
So Hammy the hamster?
Yes.
Oh, rest his soul, bless him. Did you get another one?
Well, yeah. But they all just died.
How long do you have before they die?
Some of them a week.
Now, Tony, you've been a gas man, a bus driver, a loadmaster, a butcher's delivery boy. Is there anything that he can't do?
Barbecue.
Can't do barbecues?
Not always. I have a bit of trouble with them sometimes.
Yeah.
Sometimes.
But men like to do barbecuing, don't they?
Yeah, we do.
And it's always burnt and horrible, isn't
it?
Yeah. Right. Exactly. Let's go and sit down and watch an expert.
The first lesson is always take care of your barbecue. Oh! For the best barbecue food, you need the freshest meat. And barbecues are excellent for using up any old scraps of meat.
Yeah! Look!
No, not Hazel's hamster.
Oh!
Now, light the Barbie.
Bob! Yeah! Whoop!
Not that Barbie, the barbecue.
Boom!
Yes. All you have to do now is just stand back and relax. And smell those rich aromas.
Oh, Blobby!
Add some chili sauce.
Oh, yeah!
Yes, not too much. And now, taste a little teeny, teeny piece to make sure it's not too spicy. There, isn't that nice? What can be more relaxing than a nice little barbecue? Perhaps with a drop of your favourite drink. The warmth of the summer sun. Peace and quiet in the garden. All you need now is a few well-chosen friends. There. Isn't that the perfect day?
Queen's Colour Squadron RAF Uxbridge Sergeant Brian Mannion. Hey, Brian, good to see you, mate.
Thank you.
Fabulous. Just a small little team here from... how many in the Queen's Colour Squadron now?
There's about 120.
120. How many movements do they have to do in their whole display?
In that particular sequence, there's about 60.
60?
But it can go up to, on a normal sequence, between 300 and 400 drill movements in one show.
I think 60 might be all right for this lot.
Well, I don't know. I won't say. But on behalf of the drill squad, I'd like to present you with a caricature drawn by Sergeant Tony Golding from the squadron.
Oh, smashing.
As a little memento, so the next time we see you.
Oh, look at that. That's great. Thanks for this. I wonder if you'll still be talking to me once my competitors ruin your team. OK, then, here's four more. Come on, I'm going to have a laugh. Thanks for this.
feels even more. So wave your hands if you're not with a man. Can I kick it? I've got, you've got, we've got everybody. I got the gift, gotta stick it in the gum. It's time to move your body. Babylon, back in business. Can I get a witness? Every girl ever made. Houston, do you hear me? Crack a truck, can you feel me? Need permission to live. I don't wanna ride, DJ, cause you're making me feel so nice. Things are gonna start, DJ, cause you're keeping me up all night. Pimpin' ain't easy, most of
to give us some marks. Give us that.
We only trusted the contestants with replica ones here, you know. We don't have anyone. Accidental discharge is going on.
No.
OK, marks for Kath?
Kath, yeah, good entertainment value there. 6 for Kath.
And David?
And 7.
Very good. Well done.
OK, then. Hazel?
Good effort, Hazel. I think I'll go for a 6 again on that.
OK. And Tony?
Tony, arm swing a little bit dodgy there at times. I think I'll go for 5.
Yeah. OK, smashing. So a little bit of catching up to do there. You hold that replica thing, horrible. And thanks very much for coming along.
Thank you very much.
All right, thanks very much, Sarge. All the best, guys. Thanks very much. What's the scores, Leah?
Kath and David have 13 points and Hazel and Tony have 11 points.
Right. What I love about this show and why I've been doing it for like 7 years, I've met some great people, I met some mad people, but this bloke is my favourite. He really is, to me, a genius. He's a great artist. It's my pleasure to introduce, or to reintroduce, Jean-Pierre Blanchard. Beautiful music, beautiful painting.
Beautiful music.
It's magnificent. Magnificent. Welcome back.
Thank you very much.
Jean-Pierre doesn't speak French very well, and I don't speak German, so we're going to go off and speak Italian.
Si, sta bene.
Oh. OK, last 10 seconds. Anything about my home. Well, the style was very good. Did you hit the ear as he's going to kill someone, his cat. Go mad if any goes on this suit. OK, let's welcome back Jean-Pierre to give us some marks. Want me?
It's good. 7 points.
7 points?
Yes.
Come on, then, back over there. What's that, David?
Yes.
What is it?
8 points for the choreography.
For choreography?
Yes.
Choreography, very good.
Choreography, it's good.
He's very artistic, this boy. Okay, let's have a look over here.
Ah.
What's that look like? Looks like Robin Cook, doesn't it?
7 points again.
7 points, yes. Okay, very good.
Because
well done.
The nose is.
Nose?
Yes, it's good.
Good nose?
Yes.
What is this? Why has he got one blue eye and one red?
Yes.
Bleu or rouge?
7 points again.
7 points.
7. Merci, Julie. Thank you very much. Bye.
You're the best. The best. What's the scores, Leah?
Kevin and David have 28 points and Hazel and Tony have 25 points.
OK, you've won. Off we go to the little room there. 10cc a plane. Have a driver. You don't remember 10cc, do you?
No, but young.
Okay. Rub it in. Yeah, Hazel.
Thank
well
you.
Done. Tone, you've
thanks.
Been smashing them. Enjoyed yourselves.
Yeah, great.
Yep.
Thanks.
Great. Thank
well
you.
Done.
Thank you.
Just get it. Get it. This is the best show in the West End, right? We're going to welcome the big bopper, Richie Valens, with two great songs from the fabulous West End, together with Buddy!
Get it, man. Clap your hands with the ladies there. Please give a welcome to that larger-than-life rock and roll star, Mr. J.P. Richardson, the big bopper.
Hello, baby.
Watch out, ladies, here he comes, the one and only, never lonely, Mr. Richie Valens.
Oh, que rico, buddy, baby.
Oh, my love, oh, my kisses, you don't know what you've been missing, oh, boy.
Oh, boy.
When you're with me, oh, boy.
Oh, boy.
That the world can't see that you
show in the world at the old Strand Theatre there. Please welcome Gus McGregor. Hi, buddy. Good to see you in 82. No, no, you obviously never ever saw Buddy Holly, did you?
No, no, a bit young for that. I was born 10 years after he died.
How long have you been in the show now?
About 5 years.
It's fantastic, isn't it?
I love it, yes. Best job I ever had.
OK, buddy, you go back on there, then. And we've got... Well, let's just see. Here we are. Four more people to ruin the best show in the country.
Here it is. Please welcome the Big Bopper and Kelly.
Hello, baby.
And Richie Valens and Terry. You don't know what you've been missing, oh boy. When you're with me, oh boy.
Oh boy.
The world can't see that you're not.
I'll be waiting tonight. There'll be no rest.
Oh boy. When you're with me, oh boy. The world can see that you're not. All right, let's rock and roll.
Thank you.
applause, ladies and gentlemen, a great cast of study. Now then, ladies and gentlemen, we have got audience little voters in the audience, so press them for your purple team or press them for your yellow team. Press your buttons now, folks. Yellows at one. There you go. We've still got some of these leftovers from the other session. Larry Grayson one. Look at that. Isn't it marvellous, eh? This is what we give him. It's unbelievable. You've got all types of things. You come on here and you get this. Could have been worse. You could have got a blankety blank checkbook and pen. Give a nice round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Who's going to do the conveyor belt? Me. Okay, Kathy, you go over there with Leah. You go through that hole. Good luck, David. All your police force mates are watching you. Go.
A case of French champagne.
And all this stuff's nicked.
A food processor. A stylish wall clock.
Quivering bloke.
A generator steam iron. A designer handbag. A pair of decorative cushions. The latest TV and DVD combi. A funky flower electric fan.
The size of that bloke!
And the fabulous cuddly toy! A designer four-slice toaster, a set of stylish glass bathroom scales, a wine basket and wine glasses, a fondue set, a see-through vacuum cleaner, the top 10 novels of your choice.
You silly woman.
Some kitchen accessories. The latest PlayStation, a pair of Art Deco vases.
Two big pots.
A canteen of cutlery. A decorative chess set on board.
Most serious thing you've got to remember. Keep your knees together. Go.
Champagne, blender, clock, iron, handbag, books, hoover, fondue set, chess set, knife set, cushions, cuddly toy, TV, little fan, PlayStation, camera.
Pots. Pots.
Pots. Pots. Camera.
Iron.
Iron.
Great. Okay, Leah. Yes. You know about all this stuff. Where's the holiday?
Oh, you're going to cast.
We come with you. We're doing nothing next weekend.
Yeah.
Well, we've got to do this, unfortunately. Have you enjoyed yourselves?
Lovely.
You were very special. Weren't they special, ladies and gentlemen? Well done, David. Right, say goodnight, Leah.
Goodnight.
We'll see you next week on the Generation Game. Stay with the BBC. It's the place to be. Goodnight, folks.
So, Jim's back next Saturday night, a bit earlier, 5:45. Next tonight on BBC One, Ruby Wax and The Waiting Game.
If you want to be a contestant on the next series of The Generation Game, write in for an application form to The Generation Game, P.O. Box 30896, London W12 6ZW. That's The Generation Game, P.O. Box 30896, London W12 6ZW.